LeVias back with another video, Infowars.com, Real Talk Ministry. I try to bring light to anything I find darkness on, and in my research into GMO foods, or what I call Frankenfood, I found a few other disturbing issues. So, we're going to hop into a clip with Jamie Oliver, explaining about a few things they put into your candies, as well as a few other products that you have no idea about, starting with shellac. Shellac is something they use to hardwood floors to give them shininess, and it's also what they've been given to manufacturers for candy to make your candy shiny, if we really needed that. And like I said, God said my people are destroyed due to lack of knowledge, so I'm trying to provide you with knowledge so at least you know what to fight against and what not to eat, what not to drink, what have you. Here it is. We're going to hop into the clips. I love y'all. See you in a minute. All right.
Okay, lovely people, here we go.
It's very, very clear that these 17-year-olds are a long way from being able to make good decisions or good choices. I need to do something about it.
Who likes the look of that? Shamon.
So today I'm going to teach this class all about the food that we eat.
Put your hands up if you like ice cream.
My goal is getting all subjects at the school at West Adams to sort of embrace food in some kind of way.
Now listen, what I want you all to do is come up here now, grab a spoon, and I want you to make your own sundae, okay? Who's first?
We got vanilla, we got cookie dough, we got some lovely raspberry sauce.
Come on, girl.
We got sprinkly bits here, we got some hard candy there, we got candy balls, we got little raspberry things.
Does it taste good, guys? This lesson is about how science is used to create food. I want to tell you about what is in some of these products. Okay. Everyone say shellac.
Shellac.
Okay, let me introduce you to shellac. This is the product that we're looking for. It's basically shiny covering. If you've ever seen a sweet that's shiny, it's kind of like a varnish, right? But it's the secretion of a female lac bug. These are collected and used not only to seal floors, but they're given to hard candies and sprinkles. It won't bite. Yeah. Just pass it along. So guys, I hope you don't mind, but I'm going to make my sundae, but just a little bit more realistic. Welcome to the wonderful world of shellac. Okay. Now, who loved the cookie dough? Put your hands up. Okay, I would like you to come with me. Come with me. Don't be scared. Now, L-cysteine is used in the cookie dough. It's like a conditioner. It keeps the doughy mixture kind of soft and nice. Let me give you the ingredients that they get that from. L-cysteine comes from, what do you think that is?
Feathers.
Yep, absolutely. That is duck feathers. Go and put it in my sundae, brother. And the next one is grape. Hair is also used as this ingredient. God bless you both. What's interesting is this can be made synthetically, but it's actually cheaper to use real human hair. Are we feeling gross now?
A little bit.
One thing's for sure is as soon as I started telling them about some of the ingredients, they started gagging and retching. They did not look happy at all. Are you enjoying your sundae now? Not so much now. You have just eaten human hair. You've eaten duck feathers. You've eaten crushed up bugs.
Oh my God.
A lot of these additives and colorings and stuff are trying to give you the sense that you're getting something you're not. You know, to make it look really strawberry-like, even though a strawberry's never gone anywhere near that ting with strawberry on. If you took a tiny little pinch or a teaspoon of most of these little toppings here, do you know how many ingredients you've just eaten? Can I show you? These are all the ingredients. Can you pull it along? Guys, can you pass it along? Oh my Lord. Let's take it around, guys. This is genuine. Every single ingredient written down. There we go. The total ingredients in these toppings here is 271 ingredients. The point of the class was to open their eyes and make them question things. You really don't know what's in some of these long, weird scientific names. And every now and again, you'll come across them, and they got some crazy-ass ingredients like that. So let me show you a real sundae.
I thought I'd make my own sundae. I just made a real simple one. Crushed strawberries. You know, there was some sort of caramelized sesame seed.
That's my strawberry sundae.
My sundae had 9 ingredients.
Milk, cream, sugar, strawberries, eggs, vanilla seeds, sesame seeds, honey, and tarragum.
9 whole ingredients.
I'm sure there was a lot you just learned in that video. It was a lot that I learned from, meeting up with his research and looking more into these foods. I bet if I told you that the government, as well as other entities, use a product called pink slime, which is just the extra fat and whatnot, just the extra, like kind of like bologna, I guess you could say, but not directly like that. But just think about the extra nonsense, the garbage. And they actually made a product out of this. It's called pink slime, and it's in currently all of your ground beef and foods. So, we're going to hop into a clip about that, and I'll be right back for you. Real Talk Ministries.
And now a startling ABC News investigation. A whistleblower has come forward to tell consumers about the ground beef a lot of us buy at the supermarket. Is it what we think it is, or is it padded with a filler the whistleblower calls pink slime? ABC's senior national correspondent Jim Avila set out to get answers.
Gerald Zernstein grinds his own hamburger these days. Why? Because this former USDA scientist, now whistleblower, knows that 70% of the ground beef we buy at the supermarket contains something he calls pink slime. Beef trimmings that were once used only in dog food and cooking oil, now sprayed with ammonia to make them safe to eat, and then added to most ground beef as a cheaper filler. It was Zernstein who, in a USDA memo, first coined the term pink slime, and is now coming forward to say he won't buy it.
It's economic fraud. It's not fresh ground beef. It's a substitute. It's a cheap substitute being added in.
Zernstein and his fellow USDA scientist Carl Custer both warned against using what the industry calls lean, finely textured beef, and is widely known now as pink slime. But their government bosses overruled them.
Why didn't you consider it beef?
Because it was a salvage product.
Leftovers.
Fat that had been heated at a low temperature and the excess fat spun out.
Here's how it's done. Those waste trimmings are gathered, simmered at low heat to make it easier to separate fat from muscle, put in a centrifuge and spun to finish the separation. Next, the mixture is sent through pipes where it's sprayed with ammonia gas to kill bacteria, and finally compressed into bricks and flash frozen for shipment to meat packers and grocery stores where it's added to most ground beef. And it doesn't have to appear on the label, because over objections of its own scientists, USDA officials with links to the beef industry labeled pink slime meat.
The undersecretary said, it's pink, therefore it's meat.
ABC News has learned the woman who made the decision to okay the mix is former Undersecretary of Agriculture Joanne Smith, a call that led to hundreds of millions of dollars for Beef Products, Inc., the makers of pink slime. When Smith stepped down from USDA, BPI's principal supplier appointed her to the board of directors, where she made at least $1.2 million over 17 years. She did not return our calls for comment. BPI says it had nothing to do with her appointment, and the USDA says, while legal then, under current ethics rules, she could not have immediately joined that board. Jim Avila, ABC News, Washington.
And we know this raises so many questions.
So there you have it, folks. Pink slime in all your ground beef, this extra fatty nonsense that they spray down with a chemical just to allow you to eat it. And it's making you sick. It's poison. It is ridiculous. So I brought light to this dark situation. Next time you're at the grocery store, I suggest you go and take a look at this meat and turn away and run the opposite direction. This is Philip LeVias signing off from Real Talk Ministry and InfoWars.com. To you and yours, God bless, and I'll see you soon.